Hello, wonderful people, and welcome back to Wind Waker. In our last episode, we did quite a lot of stuff, including getting the last pearl from Jebin, the sea spirit, in the back of our home island. And now that we're still on an outside island, I just want to do a couple more things before we leave and go set the pearls back where they belong on these few different places that the King of Red Lions have set out for us. So one of them is like one we actually been to before. It was Eastern Triangle Island, so we have to go to these three places. But first, we're going to duck underneath of our grandmother's house and see what's under here. There's this little space we can crawl under. So that's an obvious, surefire sign that there's something cool to be got underneath here. Let's see what it is. I wonder if Grandma knows it's here. I wonder if Grandma put it here. If so, we're kind of stealing from her, I guess. Let's see, what is it? It's an orange rupee, which is the first one of these that we've gotten. It is just one of these is worth 100 rupees. Your face is beaming. It absolutely is. Last time we did get a silver rupee from a treasure chart map that we went ahead and pulled up. But this is our first orange rupee, so that's pretty cool. Alright, and there's one more thing I want to do here that is going to help us immensely. We're going to go back up. I don't know if you guys remember or not, but we're going to go back up to where we originally found Tetra after that giant bird dropped her in the forest. We're going to go back up to that forest and take a gander around. There was something there that we couldn't quite do yet. I don't know if you guys have any recollection of that. Oh, there's some shoes. We don't want to deal with them right now. I'd rather not. I really don't feel like it at the moment. And there's nothing that they have that I care about. So let's go ahead and make our way up here. There was this stone inside. This big old stone inside of the, we'll get that green rupee at some point, but not right now. There's this great big old stone block, a boulder, I guess, in, oh gosh, not these things. I hate these things so much, and I'm going to ignore the crap out of them, because I do not want to deal with them right now. I hate those things so much. They are the worst. The absolute worst. So let's go ahead and get right on up here. We're going to climb here. That bridge is gone now. That bridge we originally used. We cannot use it anymore. I think the wind is actually blowing in the perfect direction already. So let's go ahead and put our Deco Leaf up. And we've got double magic now, so it'll be a cinch getting all the way across. Because, we're not even going to drain half of our magic, I don't think. Nope, we're perfectly fine. Awesome. So, let's go ahead and go on in. Now that we have bombs, we can, and I did actually bought in between episodes more bait, because we're almost out of bait, and more bombs, because we're almost out of bombs. Because I used a bunch of them to get to Jabin. So we're going to use these bombs to blow up that boulder inside here that we couldn't get through before. So there should be a Boca Blade in here. Actually, nope. They changed the enemy in here to one of these annoying things. Oh wow, we killed it in two hits. Awesome. Well, maybe if we come back, we'll, actually, I guess, oh, I don't think it doesn't really matter. It's not going to leave anything important. It's not going to leave anything that I care that much about. Let's go ahead and load this right up and head right on inside. I wonder what this sign says. I don't know if we read it the first episode or not. So it leaves a little heart for us, too. Awesome. I don't know if we need that or not. Oh, we do. We do have half heart missing. So, Fairy Fountain Site. This spot marks the remains of an ancient fairy fountain. The legendary hero was said to come here after battle so the fairies could ease its weariness. It also said that whoever met with the great fairy who lived here was blessed with great fortune, so it came to be known as the Fountain of the Fortune Goddess. So I don't know if that gives you guys any hints as to what we're going to find in here, but it should. It definitely should. Which is really cool. It's kind of adding to the lore about the ancient hero that Link is dressed as right now that we learned about in the first episode. So there's another great fairy, of course. And this one is going to give us another little upgrade that it's kind of an upgrade that we've already gotten before, but this is another one, an even better one. Young Waker of the Winds, allow me to aid you in your quest. So we have gotten this gift once before, but it's going to extend that gift even further than before. This is the last time we can extend it, actually. And that's perfectly fine, because we really don't need any more. So we can carry more rupees, we can carry up to 5,000. So 5,000 is quite a lot, and that's the limit. That's the highest we can go. Fairies in this fountain shall ease you from your weariness. So we can definitely grab more fairies if we want to. I think we already have one in a bottle, and we have a bottle of Grandma's elixir soup. So we don't need any fairies right now. So we're not going to deal with them. And I'll just go ahead and meet you back outside. Anyway, let's go ahead and make our way back to the King of Red Lions. Now that we have both of the rupee purse upgrades, we no longer have to listen to me complain about not being able to get more rupees when we find them, which I'm sure we're all looking forward to. So there's a ring of light over here as well that we can go ahead and grab. Gotta put the sail on. Put the sail on and make our way right over here. Try to get right on it and not lose it. There we go. Oop, oop. Kind of went too far. Dang, that stinks. Okay, let's go back a little bit. Straight back the way we came. Kind of listen for the sound a bit. Maybe right here. Let's give this a shot. Oh, there we go. Perfect. You can usually tell by the noise growing louder and louder. It's like the shining, the bright shining noise. Now, I'm not sure what's in here. I'm sure it'll be a rupee of some sort. Not sure how much, though. It could be any one of the denominations of rupee. Really just depends. Oh, it's a purple rupee, so this one's worth 50. That's just great. It is great. Purple is my favorite color, and that is a great purple. So let's go ahead and make our way to the first island on this thing, which is right here is D5. We actually don't know what this one is yet, but we can go right through Shark Island, diagonally northeast, and it'll be a straight shot to D5. We're actually in Shark Island right now, and there's these rings of light up here that I think would be cool to get real quick. I'm not sure what is in them, but we might as well try to get all four of them real quick while we're here. You guys can see, I don't know if you remember in the last episode, but that giant cyclone is right there. We gotta make sure we avoid that. We gotta make sure we keep an eye on it, make sure it doesn't get too close to us, because if it does, then we're kind of screwed, because it sends you to a completely random place on the map, which is not what we want in the slightest. I mean, hey, maybe it could send us to one of the places that we want to be, but it's very unlikely. So we got a red rupee. That's a pleasant surprise, absolutely. So the other ones, I guess, are just right around here as well. Let's go ahead and keep a listen in for them. Maybe right here. Nope. Okay, let's go ahead and go up a little bit farther. Maybe right here. Nope. And I'm going to go ahead and go away and then come back. And actually, there's five of them. Wow. So I do want to keep an eye out for this. It looks like if you look at the bottom left, it's supposedly supposed to start getting into daytime, start getting sunnier, but it just started raining, which is just adding to the bleak bleariness. We've been through so much rain and darkness the past episode and a half, I guess, or the past two episodes. It's been very bleak. Hopefully the sun starts to come out soon. Let's see what's in this one. They might all be red rupees, I'm not sure. If they're all red rupees, then that's fine. Oh, this one's a yellow rupee, so it's worth 10. It's not too shabby, like it says, it's not too shabby. I do think I'll just go ahead and leave a tiny bit and then come back to make sure I get them all, because I don't want to guess, because it just could take a while with me just guessing and listening for the noise and just barely being off without being able to see them. I think maybe just a little bit farther, so I think maybe I can get the next one without having to sail away first, but we'll see. Let's see what this one has to offer us. I wouldn't be surprised if it was a slightly smaller or a very slightly bigger one that we've gotten already. There's a red one, so it's actually the same thing. Awesome. Alright, so let's go ahead and maybe just go forward a couple of inches, and maybe right there. Nope. No dice. So actually, since it's starting to get sunny outside, they disappear. They only appear at nighttime, so we'll have to come back for them at some point later on, which is perfectly fine. We'll just go ahead and go straight on to the next quadrant. I just want to avoid that cyclone as much as possible. But I'll meet you in the next one. Looks like we're about to get there. Ugh, these annoying things. Not cool. Leave me alone. Get away from me. For real. I do not want to deal with you. So the merman's over there. Let's go ahead and stop at the island real quick. This is a very, very small, very simple island that, Oop! Well, it knocked us off for us. Don't have to do any work. It'll jump out. Just get knocked off. So let's go ahead and go up here. Like I said, this is a very simple little island. There's not anything to do here, really, except for what we're about to do, which is place the pearl in this thing's hand. So we just walk right up to it, and it automatically goes from there. Wandering traveler who seeks the guidepost of the goddesses, place the pearl you hold here. So the little symbol will match the symbol on the pearl. All the symbols on each pearl is different. I'm not sure which pearl this one is that we just placed. Can't remember what the different symbols are. You place Nyru's pearl in the ancient statue's hand. So this is the one that Jabin just gave to us. Two pearls remain. So let's go ahead and make our way to the next island, first stopping off at the merman for this one. I think he's just right past here. Hopefully we don't get knocked off again by one of these things. It'd be very preferable not to have that happen. We're all stocked up on bait and stuff now too, so we should be able to get all of the- oop! I accidentally put the grappling hook out. Well, that's just really fine. It'll put it away for us in a second. As soon as he starts talking to us, it should put it away or just- oh, I just want to just leave it out, whatever. Oh, a small fry! Yeah, yeah, I've heard. Blah, 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 blah. You guys have heard this spiel far too many times, I'm sure. Yep, I did put it away. There we go. So what is this place called? It's one of the Triangle Islands. It's Southern Triangle Island. A famed pictographer? Why don't you just call it photographer? Pictographer lives far to the north of here on Windful Island. He's apparently real wise and talented in the ways of pictography. He's even said to have legendary pictographs that he treasures above all other things. He keeps them hidden away in a secret safe, or so they say. By the way, small fry, what exactly is a pictograph anyway? And that's all the info I've got to offer. How do you tell us all the information without even knowing what a pictograph is? I should have seen that coming. They really just ganged up on us. So what we need to do now is make our way up to the next one. Let's see, where are we? So let's go ahead and change the wind and make our way up north to Six Eye Reef, and we'll go straight past there into this next one, which is D3, right below Windfall Island, and place the next pearl there. Oh, okay, so there's another one of these big, giant cyclones in this one. Of course there are. We gotta avoid this as much as we possibly can. We gotta really give it a wide berth. Because it moves, I don't know if you can tell, but it's moving, and it's like, if we get even close to it, even remotely close to it, it'll pull us up, it'll suck us up into it. And it's really chasing after us. Ugh. I hate these things. They're such a pain in the butt. Okay, I think we're good. I think we can head more straight toward the island now. Okay, good. We did it. Let's go ahead and go over to the fish real quick before we stop off at the island and see what he has to say. There's that ship of those guys again. We already talked to them, though, so they don't have anything else to do for us. Let's go ahead and talk to the fish and avoid the Octoroks. Ooh, not him. Don't want to lie. I'll target him. Okay, wait, there we go. Yeah, so this fish is surrounded by Octoroks. I must be his bodyguards. Hopefully he can call them off for us. Looks like he frees time for us. Hoi, small fry! So we're perfectly protected when we're talking to them, which is awesome. Everything just kind of freezes around us. And we've got almost all of D completely filled in now. So this is Northern Triangle Isle, which makes sense. Another one of the Triangle Isles to place the pearl on. Let me tell you something, small fry. The school on that Windfall Island has one gorgeous teacher. But the thing is, this gang of four little hoodlums is always causing trouble for her. Those little delinquents like to cause all sorts of trouble. They go climbing trees and hiding behind buildings instead of going to school. What a bunch of savages. Somebody's got to scold those scoundrels and set them straight for the sake of that poor teacher. You hear me, fry? That's all the info I've got to offer. So it's really strange to me that he knows the goings on of Windfall Island. I guess there's only one... Yeah, he's only the quadrant right below, but you know, it's still kind of strange that he knows so much. I just kind of ran right into that thing, didn't I? I needed to turn around to get back to the island, which is over there, which is unfortunate because it's going exactly in the opposite direction of the wind, so it might be slow going, but yeah, it's weird that they know about something happening in a different quadrant, but okay, come on. We're gonna inch our way there. I don't feel like changing the wind just to get there. Let's just go ahead and jump out and swim over. But yeah, I don't know if you guys remember or not. The school teacher, we talked to her in one of the first episodes when we went to Windfall Island, and she kind of told us already about that situation. So with the four kids. Now I'm not sure which one this is. I think this one is Dinsborough, wandering traveler who seeks the guidepost of the goddesses. Place the pearl you hold here. So the symbols match once again. And I'm pretty sure this is the one that Prince Kamali had. So that would make it Din's Pearl, right? I think so. Yep, you placed Din's Pearl in the ancient statue's hands. One pearl remains. So the last one is, I can't remember what it's called, but it's the one that the Deku Tree gave us. And so let's go ahead and make our way over there. We're actually going to sail east to this place right here, this unknown quadrant, and then we'll go ahead and go down to Eastern Triangle Island after that. So here in this quadrant, the first thing we notice, of course, is this platform, which we can go ahead and go up onto real quick and take care of. I'm not sure what's up here. I'm sure it'll just be another Bokoblin ready to attack us. And of course there's bombs going off, cannons going off, which we don't actually need to destroy. For this one, it's mostly just the ones that have three platforms that need to be destroyed, I'm assuming at least. I've never really thought about destroying the cannons on these before, because I'm pretty sure it's unnecessary. So let's go ahead and... Actually, I don't know why I did that. I really should have gotten this joy pendant first, though. I wonder how many joy pendants we have. We have 35 joy pendants, though, so that's pretty decent, regardless. And, okay, we didn't kill him all the way, so we can still grab him, and him, and you, sir. So I've got all your joy pendants now. I just knocked those two guys off. All three of them got knocked off. Wonderful. Don't have to deal with them anymore. And there's just a few small, minor things up here. I didn't get anything that those guys were holding, like any rubies they might have had, which is kind of sad, but it's alright. Alright, well that was fun. And real quick, we'll talk to this island's merman and see what he has to say. Oh, and in the distance there, you can see we must have a treasure chart for this island, because there's a big beam of light over there. That means we can go grab something from there. We can go ahead and pull something up that we have a treasure chart for. Oh, we didn't quite make it. There we go. Alright, so there's one thing we can do on the island, and then we can also grab that thing, whatever that thing happens to be, that our treasure chart is leading us to. So, ahoy, small fry! Let's see, I'm not sure what this place is called, but it's definitely one of the fairy islands. It is, Eastern Fairy Island, which makes sense. We got Northern, Southern, and now Eastern Fairy Island. Because this one's off to the east. Word is, they hold an auction every night over there on Windfall Island. Every night, the people gather in the Hall of Wealth to amuse themselves by spending a little money. Ah, the rich. Auction may be a race to see who can bid the highest, but I'll let you in on a little secret. The key to winning an auction is to be both patient and bold. I'm serious, Fry. From what I hear, they get some great things up on that auction block, too. Like heart-shaped stuff, among other things. Maybe that's just a rumor. You should try it out, Small Fry. You might just like it. So that's a little hint about Windfall. These things do have quite a lot to say about Windfall, which makes sense because Windfall has the most things to do on it. It is the island with the most stuff. And like he just kind of described to us, it is entirely possible to get a piece of heart from that auction. Let's go ahead and slow down and inch our way. Inch our way, you guys can hear. We're getting there. We're right next to it. Let's go ahead and pull this up. We should be fine doing it like this. It might be on the other side. Nope. Good. Sometimes you have to switch to the other side, switch the grappling hook to the other side. But it looks like we're perfectly fine. And let's see what's in this one. I'm not sure what's in this one. I wasn't aware that we'd be running into one of these. Let's see what it is. It's a silver rupee. One is worth a whopping 200 rupees. It's time to jump for joy. So we got our second silver rupee of the game. Pretty awesome. A lot of those treasure charts do lead us to silver rupees, so they're quite handy to collect. And look, the mailbox is dancing for us. Let's go ahead and see what it has to say. Well, not see what the mailbox has to say, see what whatever letter is in there has to say. Good evening. Letters for Rhodes? We have one letter. Here's your letter. Who's it from? How are you doing, Rhodes? Do you have enough granny soup? Where are you now? You may be closer than I suspect. Are you hungry? Are you keeping warm? You haven't injured yourself, have you? You always work so hard, Rhodes. Do you have enough rupees? Your grandma doesn't have a lot, but I'm sending you everything I've saved up. As long as I have you and Ariel, I don't need anything else. I just want the two of you to return home safely. Aw, love grandma. She sent us a red rupee. We stole an orange rupee that's worth 100 rupees from a chest underneath her house. I feel so bad. Oh, and there's a blue choo-choo. These things are electrified. You kind of have to beat them with the boomerang first before you can attack them. Stun it first and then beat it. I'm not sure if it leaves blue chew jelly or if it leaves something else. It does. I'm not sure if this is the first time. Yep, it's the first blue chew jelly we've ever gotten. This one is a gelatinous essence that is said to be a magical cure-all. It can't be used in its current form. Just like the other ones, we have to get it made into something else. So let's go ahead and bomb this giant boulder and see what lies within this great fairy cavern. Perhaps it's another great fairy, I don't know. This one is another one that we actually already gotten before. We've already gotten an upgrade on this thing before, so you might be able to already tell what it is. But it's another upgrade we've already gotten before, and this is, once again, the second and last upgrade we can get for this thing, just like the Ruby Purse. So, Young Waker of the Winds, allow me to aid you in your quest. Let's see what she has to give us. It's another wonderful gift. That will absolutely come in handy. I love the look on Link's face every single time this happens. We got a bomb bag upgrade. We can now carry 99, which is more than we'll ever need at once. So, fairies in this fountain shall ease your weariness. We don't need any fairies right now, Just like at the beginning of the episode, we already have the same thing, which is funny because Grandma just sent us a letter asking if we have enough soup. We haven't used any of her soup yet, but she's very nice to ask, very kind to ask, very kind to wonder where we are. Let's go ahead and I will meet you guys down here on Easter Triangle Island where we will place the last pearl. Awesome, we're approaching the island. It looks like we actually have another treasure chart that is leading us to another beam of light. Let's see, what is this one? I'm not sure. I didn't know we had another one that we'd be running into. There we go. Looks like we can see us at the top left corner of this little map. Okay, we're almost there. We don't want to go too much past it. Go ahead and stop right here. Go a little bit. We can hear the sound. I think we're right on top of it. I think we're good. This should be good. If this isn't good, then we just need to inch up just a tiny bit more. Okay, so this is perfect. Once again, I'm not sure what's in here, but we're getting quite a lot of our treasure charts satisfied in these past couple episodes, which is really great. It's always awesome to get these things out of the way while on our way to do other things. So we got another silver rupee. Another silver rupee worth another 200 rupees. So we got over 1,000 now, which is awesome. So let's go ahead and place the very last pearl and see what happens. And of course, it has to start symbolically raining as we climb the peak. Go up here, climb this little ledge, and get up here to the statue and place the last pearl. Wandering traveler who seeks the guidepost of the goddess, place the pearl you hold here. I honestly can't remember which one this is called. I think it's Narore's pearl or something like that. We'll see, I guess it'll tell us. You placed Farore's pearl in the ancient statue's hands. Awesome. So, I love this part so much. This part is great. Keep an eye on the statue and watch what it does. Keep an eye on Link as well, if you can. Look at his face, he's so confused. Something was about to happen and it didn't happen. And he climbs up again, and bad idea, Link. Bad idea. Bam! Bye-bye, Link. So this beautiful goddess statue just comes out from underneath. So this would happen no matter which order we did this in. We could have done these in any order that we wanted to. The same basic thing would have happened. It would have just done it in a different order. This little cutscene would have happened in the whatever order that we would have done it in, so. That's awesome, look at that. So the three triangle islands connect to one another to create a Triforce. Then creates another cool little thing right in the middle of them. And it's this awesome, awesome, gigantic tower that just bursts out of the sea. Oh, I love this. I love this part. I love this next part of the game so much. I can't wait. I'm really, really excited. Link doesn't seem too excited, though. He just face-planted into the wall. What a spectacular face-plant it was. Luckily, the King of Red Lions here. King of Red Lions is here to save us. And let us on. He's like, come on, Link, get on the boat. That is just awesome. So, that was not there before, and it's there now. Which is just really, really cool. So let's go ahead and see what the King of Red Lions has to say. This tower, which the pearls of the gods have caused to appear, is a place that the gods of the ancient world prepared so that they might test the courage of men. Only one who is able to overcome the trials that await here will be acknowledged by the gods to be a true hero. Only then will that hero be permitted to wield the power to destroy the great evil. Rhodes, that which you must obtain now lies before you. You must believe in your own courage, which has led you to triumph over the many hardships you have faced, and you must triumph once again. You must rise above the trial of the gods. So that is where we're going to go ahead and end the episode for today, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll go ahead and enter this tower and see what awaits us inside the test of the gods and see what we have to do, but thank you guys so much for watching. Really hope you're enjoying it so far, and I will see you in the next episode of Wind Waker.